Hey, welcome back to Kevin Wilson SBC. Today absolutely did not go as planned. Wanted to go out and put the 48 on some sticky surfaces and see how it launched, but we ran into some trouble. However, we did capture some burnouts in the driveway at the shop. I was able to collect some data. Please remember to like and subscribe to the channel. The last time we cranked the 48 up and was able to collect some data on it, we had a very lean miss in it. And we went back and talked to Mike at Alky Digger, and Mike wanted us to change the nozzle sizes in the hat, and he wanted me to change the pill in the for the bypass. So we've made all those changes, but since we've made all those changes, we've not really been able to crank the 48 up and take it out and test it. However, I was able to collect some data, and we are very fat now. We are much, much richer than we were. Also, I have the timing very conservative. I have the timing locked in at 30 degrees. From my understanding, a lot of roost blowers run a little more timing than the turbo cars. They like more timing. I'm actually being told I probably need to get the car around 34 degrees. You will see in the videos, we have the front end very, very tight. It's trying to lift the front end, and we have very limited travel on the front end right now. We're going to be changing that when we switch over to some Southside Machine Shop upper control arms, fully adjustable upper control arms. I'll show you a picture of those right now while I'm talking. Those will be going on the car soon. We're going to get a lot more lift out of the car. We're going to load the car up on the trailer and go out today, and when we cranked it, it was making a terrible clanging, rattling noise. We immediately shut it off, got into the car and inspected it, and the flywheel was completely loose. So hey, I remember putting the flywheel on. I thought I had put some red Loctite on and went back and torqued those. Obviously, I did not. We had to take the converter loose, slide the converter back as far into pump as we can get it. We made us a wrench. We had to grind on a wrench a lot to get it up in there and get on each bolt and at least get them snugged up. The whole goal today was to collect some data and make sure we had it a little richer. However, that time we lost meant that we weren't going out anywhere other than the shop driveway. So these videos are in the shop driveway now. We got to take the transmission loose. We're going to replace the flywheel. We're going to go to the smaller diameter flywheel to see if we can spin the motor a little quicker on the start. And we're going to put some red Loctite on these flywheel bolts and get them torqued in. We did go with a 1-inch taller upper ball joint, and we have a 1/2-inch taller lower ball joint, which greatly improves the camber curve and greatly helps for bump steer and keeps the Gbody from towing in and out so bad on compression and rebound. Hey, let's take a look at these videos. You'll get to see me foot braking it first, then coming up on the two-step. I'll show you some data log that we captured so you can see exactly what's going on. Thank you so much for your support. Let's take a look at the videos.
just want you to take a look at this. At 4.896 seconds into the data log, we are not on the throttle, 1,060 RPMs, negative pounds of boost, and I'm getting ready to mat it to come up on the two-step. I mat it, come up on the two-step, and as you can see here, at 5.116 seconds, I'm already at 16 pounds of boost. So in 0.2 seconds, 16 pounds of boost is in on this Roots blower. Then as we come up on the two-step, I let go of the button, and then we're on for our quick one-second burnout. And as you can see here, very, very fat on the AFRs. Too fat. We're going to have to change the bypass pill for sure to get a little more fuel to the tank. But then as we come through the run, come on through, I'm in it for just a click over 1 second and then lift. You can see our fuel pressure is approaching 180 pounds of fuel pressure. Oil pressure is good. Battery voltage is low. I need to check the alternator.
Hey, I hope you enjoyed watching those videos. I enjoyed getting out there with Dad today and doing this. Any day I can spend capturing video and working with Dad is a precious day. And we're not promised tomorrow. We lost our mom in August the 8th. My mom would have loved to seen what we've gotten so far on the 48 Ford, but you know what? Treat every day like it's a special day. Hey, please stay tuned for more front-end work on the 48 Ford. We're going to do everything we can to get this car out to a track before the track closes for winter. And just remember, go fast, go straight, and be safe.